Hello everyone, welcome to Accountancy class. I am Divya, lecturer in Commerce, GSIPU College, Mysore. Today in the session, let us discuss about goodwill valued as per AS 26 12 marks problem from chapter 4, session 4, retirement of a partner. Let's get started. So here in this question, Akash, Prithvi and Sagar are partners sharing profits in the ratio of 5:3:2 on 31st 3 2018. Their balance sheet is given below. So on the liability side, capitals, Akash 72,000, Prithvi 41,500, Sagar 34,500. Reserve fund 18,000, sundry creditors 12,400, outstanding expenses 1,600. On the asset side, building 40,000, machinery 46,500, investments 28,000, furniture 7,700, stock 18,500, sundry debtors inner column 17,200, less RBD 1,200, outer column 16,000, cash in hand 23,300. So total 1,80,000. Adjustments. Prithvi retires on the above date and the following adjustments are agreed upon. Stock is valued at 17,200 and furniture increased by rupees 800. Buildings appreciated by 10% and machinery depreciated by 5%. RBD is no longer necessary. Goodwill is valued at 18,000. Prithvi is to be paid rupees 20,000 immediately on retirement and the balance was transferred to his loan account. Prepare revaluation account, partner's capital account, balance sheet of the reconstituted firm. So first you should read the question carefully. After going through the question, note down the items which are to be recorded in the balance sheet. See the on the liability side. So capitals, it appears in the partner's capital account, mark down there P. Reserve fund, you are recording that one in the partner's capital account, it is represented in P. Sundry creditors in the balance sheet. Outstanding expenses balance sheet. If there is any adjustment relating to the outstanding expenses, then you are recording in the revaluation account. Next, on the asset side, building balance sheet, machinery, it appears in the balance sheet, investments, it will be recorded in balance sheet, furniture balance sheet, stock balance sheet, sundry debtors balance sheet, cash in hand balance sheet. So if there is any adjustment, you just write in front of that asset star mark, it indicates that there is an adjustment for that particular item. In the first adjustment, Prithvi retires on the above date and the following adjustments are agreed upon here. The partner who will get retired here, Prithvi. So in the first adjustment, stock valued 17,200. So in the balance sheet, they are given the value 18,500. You should compare there whether there is an increasing in that particular asset or decrease in the asset. Because here in the adjustment, it is valued 17,200. That means decrease in the value of the stock. Furniture increased by 800. So they are already given the value of the furniture in the balance sheet. Now it is increased by 800 rupees. That should be recorded in the revaluation account credit side. Next one, building appreciated by 10% and machinery depreciated by 5%. Once you are recording in the revaluation account, again in the balance sheets. Whatever the adjustment is given, it will be affected twice, once in revaluation account or in partner's capital account as well as in the balance sheet. RBD is no longer necessary. No longer necessary. No longer anta helidre innu munde adu balance sheet alli RBD anta helodu record maadbardu. Once it recorded in revaluation account, again in balance sheet. Goodwill is valued at 18,000. Next adjustment, Prithvi is to be paid 20,000 immediately on retirement and the balance was transferred to his loan account. Partly paid in cash, other half it is transferred to loan account, revaluation account, write debit and credit, then write the particulars column, amount, particulars column and amount. Now see the adjustment. First adjustment, stock is valued at rupees 17,200. Andre illi increase agidya decrease agidya amount anta neevu tilkolbekandre neevu balance sheet alli kottirthakanta amount jothe compare maadbeku. So balance sheet alli est amount kottidare 18,500. In adjustment they are given 17,200. That means there is a decrease in the value of the stock. Record on the credit debit side to stock account. So what is the value given in the balance sheet? 18,500 minus 17,200. So when you deduct, you will get 1,300. Next, furniture increased by 800. Ivaga irthakanta balance sheet alli irthakanta furniture amount 800 rupees hechagide. That means increase in the value of furniture. Record on the credit side, buy furniture. Furniture account 800 rupees. Next, building appreciated by 10%. The value of the building increased to 10%. So buy building account. So what is the value given in the balance sheet? 40,000 into 10 divided by 100 equals to 4,000. Next, machinery depreciated by 5%. Decrease in the value of the asset means you should record on the debit side of the revaluation account to machinery account. So what is the value given in the balance sheet? 46,500 into 5 divided by 100 equals to 2,325 rupees. Next, RBD is no longer necessary. Balance sheet alli munde adanna RBD antakkada items na neevu record maadabardu. That means, so you record on the credit side, buy RBD. Reserve for bad debts 1,200. Question alli kottirthakkanta balance sheet alli debtors inner column 17,200 less RBD 1,200 outer column 16,000 kottidare. No longer necessary andre new balance sheet alli idu appear aagbardu 1,200. That means when you record on the credit side, the value of the debtors increases. Debtor comes under asset. When asset increases, you are recording on the debit side of the asset account. So revaluation account credit side alli bariri RBD equals to 1,200. So in the new balance sheet, debtors value is 17,200. Now you add the credit side, you will get 6,000. Write the same amount on the debit side, 6,000. When you deduct these two amounts, you will get 2,375. This amount is the balance transferred to partners capital account. Who are all the partners here? Akash, Prithvi and Sagar. So the total profit in this account is 2,375. Their profit sharing ratio is 5:3:2. When you add these three numbers, you will get 10. 5/10, 3/10 and 2/10. So distribute in their profit sharing ratio 5/10. You'll get 1,188. Next one, 2,370. 5 × 3/10, you'll get 712. Next one, 2,375 × 2/10, you'll get 475. When you add these three numbers, you should get 2375. Next, partner's capital account. Write the heading partner's capital account debit and credit, particulars, then Akash, Prithvi and Sagar. Here Prithvi get retired. Again on the credit side, particulars are partner Akash, Prithvi and Sagar. First, bring the partner's capital account balance from the balance sheet by balance brought down. See the question. So the Akash is 72,000 capital amount. Next one, Prithvi 41,500. Next, 34,500. Next, see the balance sheet. In the balance sheet, they are given the reserve fund. Bring that reserve fund to the partner's capital account by reserve fund account. So what is the amount given in the balance sheet? That is 18,000. Distribute this one in their profit sharing ratio 5 by 10, 3 divided by 10 and 2 divided by 10. So you'll get 9,000, 5,400 and 3,600. Next, bring the revaluation account balance by revaluation account. That is 1,188, 712 and 475. This is the balance arrived in the revaluation account. Next, see the adjustment. There is an adjustment for goodwill. So your firm's goodwill equals to 18,000. The retiring partner is Prithvi. So Prithvi share of goodwill equals to 18,000 into this share is 3 by 10. So the old profit sharing ratio is 5 is to 2, 3 is to 2. 5 plus 3 plus 2 equals to 10. Here Prithvi retires, so her his share is 3 by 10. So 18,000 into 3 by 10 equals to 5,400. When goodwill is valued as per AS 26, the journal entry is gaining partners capital account debited to retiring partner capital account. So the gaining ratio is when Prithvi get retired, gain ratio is 5 is to 2. So gaining partner's capital account debited to retiring partner's capital account. So journal entry is, that is Akash account debited, Sagar account debited to Prithvi's account. So total goodwill of Prithvi is 5,400. So it is distributed in the gain ratio, that is 5,400 into gain ratio. Here gain ratio is 5 is to 2. So 5,400 into 5 by 7. Again 5,400 into 2 by 7. It comes to 3,857 and 1,543. So then it should be recorded in partner's capital account. So by Akash account, that is 5,400 into 5 by 7 equals to 3,857. By Sagar account, that is 5,400 into 2 by 7, it comes to 1,543. So actual journal entry is Akash account debited, Sagar account debited to Prithvi account. So here to Prithvi account. So Akash account debited to Prithvi account, that is 3,857. Sagar account debited to Prithvi account, the amount is 1,543. This is the goodwill adjustment according to AS 26. So, nivili Akash account anta bandirvaga, Akash account alli amount anna bariyalla. Hage Sagar account anta bandirvaga, Sagar account alli amount anna baribardu. Now, Prithvi account alli record martivi. Illi Prithvi name bandirvaga, Prithvi account alli amount baribardu. Yakanta helidre Akash account and Sagar account is debited to Prithvi account here. So the amount is, that is 3,857 and 1,543. The next one, the last adjustment, Prithvi is to be paid rupees 20,000 immediately on retirement and the balance was transferred to his loan account. The cash paid immediately is 20,000 to cash account, that is 20,000 here. So retiring partners due partly paid in cash, that is 20,000. So let us total the partners capital account. First let us total the retiring partners capital account. So the total of retiring partners capital account is 53,012. Write the same total on the debit side, 53,012, and find the balance, 33,012. So the balance amount is transferred to loan account. To loan account, this is balancing figure. So the balance amount is transferred to loan account. Next, let us balance the Akash account, that is 82,188. Write the same total here, 82,188. The balance is 78,331. So the total of Sagar account is 38,575. Write the same total, 38,575. The balance is, this is two balance carried down. So here the cash is, amount is partly paid to the retiring partner immediately and the balance amount is transferred to loan account. The goodwill treatment according to AS 26, first we have to find out the retiring partner share of goodwill. In the question, the firm goodwill will be given. So from that one, retiring partner's share of goodwill has to be calculated, then it should be distributed to the gaining partners. Here Akash and Sagar are gaining partners. It should be distributed in their gain ratio. The old ratio is 5:3:2. Here Prithvi get retired, so the remaining ratio is 5:2. This remaining ratio is said to be the gain ratio. So in that 5:2 ratio, it should be written off in the gain ratio by the gaining partners or remaining partners. Next, balance sheet. Write the heading balance sheet as on 1/4/2018. Liabilities, amount, assets and amount. Now see the previous year balance sheet, that is sundry creditors is given on the liability side. Bring that balance, sundry creditors. Sundry creditors. What is the amount given sundry creditors? 12,400. Then outstanding expenses is there. Bring that one, outstanding expenses. What is the amount given outstanding expenses? 1,600. Next, on the asset side, building is given. Buildings. The actual value of the buildings is 40,000 add appreciation. So what is the appreciation amount you already calculated in the revaluation account? 4,000. So total outer column 44,000. Next, machinery is there. Right, machinery. So the actual value of the machinery is 46,500. your depreciation you calculated in the revaluation account. What is the value calculated depreciation? 1235. So when you deduct, you will get 44,175. Next, investments is there. There is no adjustment for investments. So the actual value of the investments is 28,000. Next, see the question. Furniture is there. Furniture. So what is the total amount of furniture given in the balance sheet? 7,700. There is adjustment record in the inner column, 7,700. Add appreciation, 800. So after adding, you'll get 8,500. Stock, what is the value of stock given in the balance sheet? 18,500. Less depreciation. So we already recorded in the revaluation account 1,300. You'll get 17,200. Next, debtors is there. Record sundry debtors. So RBD is no longer necessary in the balance sheet. So what is the actual value of the debtors? Is 16,000 in the outer column. Add RBD 1,200, you will get 17,200. Next, cash in hand. Cash in hand. So the actual value of the cash in hand, 23,300 minus retiring partners amount is paid immediately, that is 20,000. After deducting, you will get 3,300. Next, bring the capital balance from the partners capital account. Kash capital 78,331 and Sagar's capital is 37,032. Next one. Prithvi's loan account is balance is transferred to loan account. Prithvi's loan is 33,012. Now you add the total, the balance sheet. So when you add, you will get 1,62,375 on the liability side. On the asset side also 1,62,375. So I hope all of you have understood this session. Thank you.